Hello guys and welcome back to the channel, another episode about the eBay turbo build for our MX5. In today's episode I'm going to show you how to install a wideband sensor and a controller, specifically the Spartan 3 Light V2 or whatever, but basically it's not the cheapest you can get, because remember this is a budget build. The cheapest you could get is like 50 quid on this kind of just a board, and you kind of do it yourself because they were out of stock. Next one up is this, a bit more straightforward, basically just a bit of wiring and then a bit of plugging, but that was £90 without the sensors, and you need to add, I don't remember the sensor, but I'll put link in the description. But yeah, so basically MX5 only got a narrow band, which means the ECU can only know whether it's something, the FAR, the air fuel ratio, is only between 13.7, I'm rushing, and 14.7, so it's why it's called narrow band. Where this will be able to give it a much further reading. I can't remember exactly, I put it on display or check the info, but I think it's like between 10 and 20 or something. Hello doggy. But yeah. Anyway, let's go. all right then. But yeah, the install is pretty easy. Basically, the new sensor go where our old O2 sensor is, and then yeah, I'll show you the wiring, and then everything just plug together.
This is where our sensor is. Depending on your reach, it might be easier to get it out of the way. I'm going to do that on mine as well. It's a just performance one. You know, if you've got a stock one, I think it's just a couple of bolts or something, but 10 mils. Those, that I believe is a 21 mil. There's also a special socket you can buy for those. I have neither, so I'm going to be using this guy. Not as good, but you know, we still get the job done. If you're this stock like mine, to start with, try WD-40, you know, sometimes let it soak, just while it's sprayed for edges. And because we are going to replace the sensor, not use the old one, what you can do is just chop it, and then 22 mil socket can go on there, and there we go, this one is coming out.
Here it is.
And then for our plug, we basically follow the line. You can see it's this line here. It's actually got disconnected, but it's basically this one here. So depending on your model, you might have four cable here, which you have, it's great for you, because less wiring basically. If you don't, like I've got a single one, then it's just a bit more wiring. But essentially, if you look at the instructions that come with it, there's basically four cables you need to hook up to make it work on this. So red, a power that should be live only when the engine is running. And black is going to be our electronic ground, so that's important, it needs to be ground where interface device is grounded, so in your case it means the same ground as the ECU. Then white is another ground, but that one we want to chassis or engine block. And then green is basically going to be the one we want to put our ECU to. Then blue is just for LED, then our bond is simulated narrow band, so that if you've got the stock ECU still, you can still send it. And basically brown will make it look like normal output. The other one are more interfaces, but we won't be using that stuff in this video. So we can take our new sensor, screw it in there, and then torque it to that much. Okay, so if you have a stock ECU still, you basically connect the brown to the original cable. If you have a custom ECU like I've got, you connect the green to it for the red. You can piggyback on this one, which I've removed because of my custom ECU, but is essentially this one. So you can get the fuse with a little breakout. And this, basically, if you don't use a brake, it's just the left side. Got 12 volt only when the car is running. And remember, we need to put a fuse on that, that is provided. Then your white is ground for the engine block. And here we've got a ground here. So now I just need to find a good ground for our ECU, and we've got all our location, and then it's just passing the wire through. Ideally, I like to find one for the ECU that is inside, because that way I could avoid having to pass any cable through the firewall. So in my case, to make it easy, I am going to use a fuse, but what I've done is, if you can see in between, I've basically break the junction. So when I put it in, this side will get powered, but this side won't. And that way, it's not a problem for my custom ECU. Obviously, again, if you still have the stock ECU, do not break the middle part, because your engine still needs that. And use the right one, that's 15 amp. This is normally 10 on your car, as indicated. Okay, so once our sensor is in, as you can see here, we can actually move it there. I'm going to get some live from here, like I've explained. We have engine block grounding here. We've got our old cable we can use to send the signal to the ECU. And the last thing we need is basically the ECU ground, which are basically that guy there, that old block there. So nice and easy, we don't actually have to run any cable through there. It's very connected. Our block ground. No, still need to connect that one actually, but I'll do it, never mind. Connected signal to the ECU and the stuff. And yeah, I still need to get a fuse in there. But yeah, all installed. So if you have a gauge, the pen stuff with the gauge, so how to test it. In my case, I've got Tuner Studio, so I'm going to jump into Tuner Studio and see whether the sensor actually works perfectly with the ECU. Alright, so once you're done with the install, USB, connect your laptop, and then you just basically want to go into Tools, Calibrate AFR Sensor. So our one is 14.7 sensor, right to controller, close, and we are done. And here we go, guys, that is pretty much it for the wideband. So overall, it's quite easy to set up, really. And yeah, you know, just next stage is basically, now we should have everything to tune it properly. I still have a little bit of exhaust work to do on mine. I've noticed that the junction after the sensor is actually not that tight, which means there will probably be air leak, which means it will throw the air fuel ratio reading, which, you know, so basically I need to sort that out. You basically don't want any leak, especially close to where the sensor is, because otherwise oxygen gets in there, and yeah, the readings are not accurate. Anyway, thank you for watching. See you in the next one. Bye bye.